Anti-continental crime begins in West Africa, where we understand investigators have handed a long-awaited report on crimes committed under ex-dictator Yahya Jammeh to Gambia's president. Investigators have urged the government to pursue criminal charges against those responsible for crimes committed under the ex-dictator. TRRC officials on Thursday handed President Adama Barrow their findings in a ceremony in the capital, Banjul. The report comes after more than 2 years of hearings into Jammeh-era crimes. The final report of the Truth, Reconciliation and Reparations Commission, TRRC, was originally scheduled for release in July, but has been delayed several times. Now, joining us tonight, an anti-continental prime from Brussels in Belgium to discuss this is Collins Nweke, a Global Affairs Analyst. Good evening, Collins. Nice to see you.
Very good evening to you, Mwenga, and thank you for having me.
Yeah, now, Collins, the long-awaited report into allegations of abuse committed during former Gambian President Yahya Jammeh's 22-year rule has been presented to President Adama Barrow. How would you rate the Truth, Reconciliation and Reparations Commission after more than 2 years of hearings into the Jammeh-era crimes?
The good news is that the report of the commission is out. The timing is a different kettle of fish. Now, I would rather that the report is delayed, that it took time, but that a thorough job is done. From all indications, it's a very voluminous one, 14,000 pages, as we have been told. And let's bear this in mind, what has been released to Mr. President is the report. The president is expected to issue a white paper, actually outlining how the report's recommendations will be implemented. So not every detail about what is contained in that report is currently in public space, but at least some snippets are already known, which is that trial prosecution is being recommended for Jammeh for the time that he was president. Right. So yes, I think it's a relief that the report is out. The delay in publishing it is another issue altogether.
Now, President Adama Barrow has urged victims and families to be patient and allow legal process to take its course, promising the government will ensure that justice is done. We do know this is an election year in the Gambia in a few weeks. Do you see him implementing the recommendations of the government to pursue criminal charges against those responsible?
Whether the prosecution of Jammeh, ex-president, is going to come to reality remains to be seen. But I think it will surprise me and other watchers of this saga unfolding in Gambia that the report that has taken so much resources, taking a lot of time, and indeed, some political risk on the part of Adama Barrow would actually be discarded without necessarily follow up on it. I hope that will not be the case. Of course, it will not surprise anyone if that becomes the case, because there have been instances in other parts of Africa where that happened. But I think it will be far-fetched for the report not to be implemented. Now, prosecution and actually charging the ex-president to court and convicting him of the crimes is another set of process.
Yes.
How that is going to play out is different, but I see a lot of politics being injected into it, but I think the implementation looks likely to be put in place.
Now, Collins, talking about politics, there's some observers in some quarters have said that President Barrow is just playing to the gallery. President Barrow has sought an alliance with Jammeh's APRC party in September, a move viewed as an electoral ploy. Do you see this affecting the outcome of the white paper?
Well, that looked like a rather opportunistic move. I mean, that of Adama Barrow trying actually to form some sort of alliances with the party of ex-president Jammeh. Now, there can only be one reason for that, a strategic one for that matter, and that is the fact that the ex-president actually still enjoys a very, very significant popularity in the Gambia. And so what Adama Barrow tried to do was essentially find ways and means of, you know, getting the supporters of the ex-president under his wing to enable him ensure, you know, or guarantee his victory in the election taking place, you know, in a matter of weeks. But, but that appears to have collapsed because while that arrangement was made with the presidential candidate, it does look like, you know, the ex-president has actually denounced it, has refused to throw his weight behind that. So that is that has become a political miscalculation. However, whether that gives us indication that, you know, Adama Barrow isn't going to actually see through to the implementation of the report, no, that's a different matter altogether. I think that, yes, he may have failed in his attempt, but that might, as a matter of fact, imbue him to take more decisive actions in terms of pursuing a trial and prosecution.
Now, finally, Mr. Collins Nweke, we do understand that former President Yahya Jammeh is in Equatorial Guinea, is in some form of asylum in Equatorial Guinea. We've seen the former president that is wanted has been subpoenaed in Burkina Faso. Former President Blaise Compaoré is currently in exile in the Ivory Coast. So we've seen a situation where ex-African presidents are investigated in their home countries, but there's almost like a, you know, old boys network. So if Jammeh is found guilty, do you think he may face punishment since under Gambian law, a former head of state cannot be prosecuted unless parliament approves proceedings by a two-thirds majority? And also, I'm not really sure if the Gambia has an extradition treaty with Equatorial Guinea. So how do we navigate those parts?
At the center of the scenario that you have just painted is, you know, the impending elections. And that is why this election is for ex-president Jammeh, a do or die. A do or die because essentially if his party wins and, you know, they deliver the presidency, or at least if they do well enough to have a significant number of seats in the National Assembly, then it means that you know, under no circumstances will he actually face any jail sentence or any sort of reprimand, even when he's convicted of you know, the crimes you know that they purported that he committed. So that is why this election is very, very important to him. Again, the old boys association, which you know, the African leaders have become, is a very despicable you know scenario where they all, as a gang of criminals, you know, I'm not saying that's what they are, but they are acting like one, as a matter of fact, where they all see, you know, themselves, you know, obliged to actually protect one another. And then the regional bodies, the ECOWAS, the African Union, appear to just be running around like a headless chicken, unable to actually stamp their foot on the ground and say up to this point and not any further. So yes, the protection that they are getting in those countries where they go for exile is always, and that is why when people say that the colonial masters, you know, are still controlling Africa, you know, remotely, yes, while that is true, I believe that they are succeeding because, you know, the current crop of, you know, old men who are ruling Africa have allowed that to continue to happen, have allowed that to continue to succeed. And so, Jammeh will not be the last. I believe that more of such, you know, ugly situations will continue to play out.
We'll definitely be monitoring the situation in the Gambia and as things unfold. So much is still going to happen in the next couple of months. As always, always a pleasure talking to you, Mr. Collins Nweke from Brussels, Belgium.
Thank you, Benga, for having me. Cheers.